Hi guys, today's movie is the 1996 Eddie Murphy comedy, The Nutty Professor. And this is a movie that, I'll have to explain what I mean here, but it's my least favorite of the Eddie Murphy movies that I like. And definitely is a milestone of, I really consider this to be sort of the marker of the end of Eddie Murphy at being really in like good comedies. To me, this movie still holds up pretty well as far as being a funny comedy, a funny remake in a very different way. They did the remake in a way that it was unique enough and different enough from the original that it was its own thing and worked pretty well. I think Eddie Murphy did a good job here. It was a little over the top with the him being seven different characters and the clumps and everything, but it worked pretty well. The makeup effects and all the special effects in here actually still hold up really, really well. And this LaserDisc in particular, I'll mention, not only is it a Letterboxd release, but like most of the late 90s releases, it looks absolutely fantastic. I mean, it's a great transfer. Everything about it, sound quality, everything is really great. So if you do like this movie and you are looking for it, this is definitely a quality release to get. It looks absolutely pristine on both sides. Stars Eddie Murphy and Jada Pinkett Smith, and they work well as far as they pull it off, this kind of ridiculous scenario as being believable. With Eddie Murphy as Professor Clump, you actually do feel for him in some scenes. It's kind of ridiculous, some of the comedy, especially with very early Dave Chappelle being the comedian who makes fun of him, braids him, and that aspect of the movie works really well. Where it kind of loses it, the clumps are funny. And here's the only time where I think the clumps, like his family works, because once you get into later ones, like the second movie, you know, the clumps, too much clumps is bad. In small doses, they can be funny, but they're the kind of thing where it's like too much of it, it just gets ridiculous. And here it's balanced pretty well. I could use a little bit less of them, but overall it's still pretty funny, it still works okay. But what it really loses it is when he takes the syndrome and he becomes his other self, and there you start to see more of newer Eddie Murphy start to shine through. And when you look at it, Eddie Murphy's career, I think where it took a turning point starting in the early to mid 90s, and this is, you know, like 95, 96, the disc came out in 96, not sure the movie was the same year or the year before, but I think what happened in my mind is if you look at his older comedies, look at Trading Places, Coming to America, 48 Hours, the first two Beverly Hills Cops, I mean, you look at all of those, there is a darker tone to them. They're not all of them are necessarily like not family friendly. I think Coming to America, most of it is pretty family friendly, but there's definitely a geared towards an older audience. There's a darker tone to them. The first two Beverly Hills Cops, you could re-edit that or have a different actor, and it wouldn't be as good, but it could still be like a half decent 80s action movie. Works so much better with the comedic elements, but I think that's where things went wrong, where his mainstream comedies really became more family friendly and more goofy, and they lost the dark elements. They lost that element that made them less of a family friendly romp, like Dr. Doolittle and The Haunted Mansion, Pluto Nash. Like, you get into all that stuff. So many comedies later on, even the Nutty Professor movies, get into Beverly Hills Cop 3, they all lost that sort of gritty edge. Even something like The Golden Child even still held on to a little bit of that and has almost like Big Trouble in Little China vibes to it and things. I think it really, he lost that edge and really became more kind of, you know, like daddy's, you know, daddy daycare and like more family friendly. And the way he did the comedy also took a little bit of a shift. If you look at the early to late 80s Eddie Murphy versus 90s Eddie Murphy, he went a little more overboard a lot of times, got a little crazier. It's almost like if you took early Eddie Murphy and gave him a little bit of like an injection of Jim Carrey, and like that's the Eddie Murphy that you got. He started, if you really look at the difference in how he plays certain scenes, trying to find scenes that kind of seem familiar as far as like how he played them in an earlier movie versus a later movie. You can really see that even in Why Beverly Hills Cop 3, which is an okay movie, doesn't quite work compared to the first two. You can see he's so much less believable, so much more cartoonish and over the top, and really puts that element in there that just makes it far less engaging. And what really worked for him was that element of that the bit of grittiness with the just kind of funny comedy. and losing that, becoming more family-friendly. He has had a couple pictures that were okay later on that I think in many ways, especially more towards his more dramatic roles, but overall it's kind of like one out of every four or five are pretty good, but still aren't really like heyday quality. And I think that this, to me, really kind of lives as a marker where it still has, I think, enough of the old Eddie Murphy to where it's funny. I do like it, and there are a couple moments in there that really, really work, where you feel for the character, and Jada Pinkett Smith is really good in here. Overall, I think, you know, those moments really work well, but it also has all those moments of what Eddie Murphy was becoming, and it's kind of a mixed bag for me in that way. It's a movie that I definitely enjoy. I think there are, again, some really, really funny scenes, and the effects still hold up really well. Definitely like the fat suit and everything and all of the clumps, and they're pretty good. But yeah, it definitely is one of those, it's my least favorite of the Eddie Murphy movies that I really like. So it's still a comedy that I enjoy, but again, it really is kind of the hallmark, I think, of like, this is what Eddie Murphy was becoming versus what he was. And I'm not sure what happened to make him go that direction. Again, there are a few late 90s, early 2000s movies that went against that were kind of okay, but I think even those roles don't really, when you think of Eddie Murphy, you don't think of those because they're just kind of in this sea of mediocrity. I think a lot of his comedies just became more goofy, more family-friendly, lost the biting edge that really made him great, and it's just sad to see it go that way. But yeah, The Nutty Professor, still, I think, after rewatching it with my wife for the first time, and I probably haven't seen that in like 10 years, I was surprised, actually, at how much I did still enjoy it. I do think it's really funny, and I do think even those elements that aren't as good, that are more later Eddie Murphy, were toned down enough. They weren't quite as crazy yet to where they became super annoying, and they were just funny, but not quite as good as his best of the best for Eddie Murphy, but definitely still a movie that I suggest that you rewatch if you haven't seen it in a very long time, and see if you still enjoy it, and see if you understand what I mean about like the transition of his comedy and where things went from there. But yeah, Eddie Murphy in The Nutty Professor, a great LaserDisc, again, great, great quality, and a movie that, not one of my favorites, but still a very funny comedy you should check out.